Students, in this session, we are supposed to learn regarding to the classification of Indian banking system. Learning objectives of this session are to define what is a bank and to know how Indian banking system has been classified. Definition of a bank. Banking means the accepting for the purpose of lending or otherwise and withdrawable by check, draft or otherwise. This definition has been given by Banking Companies Act of India 1949. Classification of Indian banking system. The picture shows how the banking system has been classified in India. Indian banking industry has been divided into two sectors. 1. Organized sector. 2. Unorganized sector. Organized sector. The organized sector consists of Reserve Bank of India, in short RBI, commercial banks and cooperative banks. In organized sector, it also consists of specialized institutions like IDBI, ICICI, IFC, etc. Unorganized sector. The unorganized sector, which is not homogeneous, is largely made up of money lenders and indigenous bankers. Here we have to understand what is the major difference between organized and unorganized sector. The banks which are supposed to follow according to the rules and regulations of RBI comes under organized sector, and the banks which are not supposed to follow the rules and regulations of RBI falls under unorganized sector. Now let us see outline of Indian banking structure. Indian banking structure has been classified into 5. First, Reserve Bank of India, in short RBI. 2. Indian scheduled commercial banks. This Indian scheduled commercial banks again subclassified into A. State Bank of India and its associate banks. B. 20 nationalized banks. C. Regional rural banks. D. Other scheduled commercial banks. 3. Foreign banks. 4. Non-scheduled banks. 5. Cooperative banks. Reserve Bank of India, in short RBI. Central Bank of a country executes multiple functions such as overseeing monetary policy, issuing currency, managing foreign exchange, working as a bank of the government and as a banker of scheduled commercial banks, etc. Here, in our country, Central Bank is supposed to called as Reserve Bank of India. Commercial banks. Commercial bank refers to a bank or a division of bank that mostly deals with deposits and loans from corporations or large business. Commercial banks perform all kinds of banking functions such as accepting deposits, advancing loans, credit creation and agency functions. Commercial banks are of three types. A. Public sector banks. B. Private sector banks. C. Foreign banks. Public sector banks. These are the banks where major stake is held by the Government of India or Reserve Bank of India. Examples: State Bank of India, Corporation Bank, Bank of Baroda, Dena Bank, etc. Private sector banks. The majority of the stake is in the hands of private individuals. Examples: the Jammu and Kashmir Bank Limited, Bank of Rajasthan Limited, Karur Vysya Bank, etc. Foreign banks. These banks are registered and have their headquarters in some foreign country but operate their branches in our country. Examples: HSBC, Citibank, American Express Bank, etc. Cooperative banks. Cooperatives owned by the depositors and often offering rates more favorable than profit banks. Membership is restricted to employees of a particular company, residents of a defined area, members of a certain union or religious organizations, and their immediate families, offering short-term and long-term credit. Cooperative banks has been broadly classified into three: A. Primary credit societies, B. Central cooperative banks, C. State cooperative banks. Primary credit societies. These are formed at the village or town level with borrower and non-borrower members residing in one locality. The operation of each society are restricted to a small area so that the members know each other and are able to watch the activities of all members to prevent frauds. Central cooperative banks. These banks operate at the district level, having some of the primary credit societies belonging to the same district as their members. These banks provide loans to their members and function as a link between the primary credit societies and the state cooperative banks. State cooperative banks. These are the apex cooperative banks in all the states of the country. They mobilize funds and help in their proper channelization among various sectors. The money reaches the individual borrowers from the state cooperative banks through the central cooperative banks and the primary credit societies. Development banks. They are essentially a multi-purpose financial institution with a broad development outlook. A development bank may thus be defined as a financial institution concerned with providing all types of financial assistance to business units in the form of loans, underwriting, investment, and guarantee operations. In this session, we have learned regarding to definition of bank and classification of Indian banking system. This session was made by Mr. M. Arjun Gupta, Department of Commerce, St. Joseph Institution. This work is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution, Non-Commercial, No Derivatives, International License.